Hi folks, welcome back to Aywenn Plays Fallout 4 with me, Aywenn, and Roawyn in the passenger seat.
Hello.
Hi. So off camera we did a lot of lugging things back from the fort, back to our thing, and sorting things, and I'll show you also what I did at my Bane base when we get back to Sanctuary Hills. But two things we found while we were going through the fort. One was a magazine.
She found nothing. Don't believe her. It's a lie. She found an energy weapons bobblehead also. You may have seen it as she was passing by.
So here's gun and bullets. We found that in the fort.
Yeah. I think they saw that because I commented on the shoot the bunny with the laser.
Right. And then the other one we got.
Another Robco Fun. Pipfall.
Yep. I think you saw that on camera, too. But the one that you didn't see...
Squeaky floorboard, sudden death.
Improved sneak.
Yep.
Oh, we never actually gone through those, either.
Oh. Yeah. We could listen to those, I suppose.
Alright, so...
You need to get out of your magazine rack, though.
Yep, but you can't. No, I don't want to throw that. So now we got all that. Let's put the bobblehead here.
I think the bobblehead for energy weapons upped a crit of lasers. So that's a thing.
Yep.
I was going to say that's the wrong section.
There it is.
Yep.
Why do I have a burnt book in here?
I don't know. You're just carrying around a burnt book.
So there's my bobblehead group. Let's go ahead and throw the burnt book in here. That's where the rest of my burnt books are. Why they're in there, I don't know, but they're there.
And then you got those cybernetics. I hope that you can get, like, cybernetic upgrades. That would be amazing and make me very happy.
Because, see, I have folders, lots of burnt books and stuff in here. Alright, so let's go ahead and listen to those logs that were in the,
Logs? Logs don't make a lot of noise. It's
audio
log. It's log. It's better than bad. It's good.
Alright, they were in Vault 114, which is the one that was made in the subway. So let's... Okay.
This is Vault Tech Interview. Number 03, for the position of overseer for Vault 114. Interview subject.
Oh, these are old. Beasley.
Mr. Beasley, as overseer of Vault 114, how would you settle a disagreement between two of your vault residents?
Well, I would obviously take it through the proper channels, assuming neither of their requests were against the law, of course. This is, of course, assuming that the conflict had already gone through all the other members of the Vault's Residence Council that I plan on organizing.
Vault Residence Council, you say?
Uh-huh.
Yes, of course. People need government. They yearn for it. I think it's a civic duty of every red-blooded American patriot to serve...
Yes, I think we have everything we need here. Thank you for your time.
Yeah.
Oh, already? Well... I look forward to hearing from you soon.
It's never good
yes,
when an interview
sure
is very short.
Please make sure to fill out your non-disclosure agreement on your way out.
Okay, and as that was playing, I came over here to Sanctuary Hill to show you what defenses I made changes. So I've got my little turret towers.
And there is one problem with these defenses. Do you want to show them?
Okay. These are not... They're gates, not actual fences.
Well, you know.
But I like these looks better than the actual fences, so we'll have to work on that. But I like the idea of having our turrets up there, and then I could put people up on the top.
As soon as you get enough citizens.
Right. Let's go ahead and listen to the next one here.
Yeah.
This is Vault Tech Interview number 21 for the position of overseer for Vault 114. Interview subject, Kimberly Weiss. Hello, Mrs. Weiss.
How do you do? And may I just say what an honor it is to even be considered for the position of overseer. Ever since I was a little girl in mock government, I dreamed that one day I would have the opportunity to lead a community of greatness.
Nope, she's out.
My teachers all told me I had leadership potential, and without my guidance as student council vice president, those bake sales surely would have failed.
Mm.
Just the thought of being able to organize and run this small group, to show them a better
way,
they're
not gonna want
to lead them to a future
the
so bright that they...
My goodness. Looks like we're out of time.
Bye.
What? We just started.
Yeah. Just...
Yes, yes. Thank you. If you could just send the next candidate in as you leave.
Of course. Did I mention I was head of my debate team?
I'm sure you did. Thank you.
All right.
And the last one.
This is Vault Tech interview number...
Apparently they were having some issues.
For the position of overseer for Vault 114. The candidate has refused to give his real name and has only provided the name... The Soup Can Harry?
That's right. I ain't telling you nothing. My name is the name I call myself, not the rank and number the government grants on me. No, sir.
Uh-huh.
Fascinating. Mr. Soup Can, would you mind telling me why you're distrustful of the government?
He's perfect.
I've seen what they do. Gum up the works with red tape and bureaucracy, take every hard-earned cent and use it to fund their Illuminati Freemason sex parties.
Woo!
I'm a free man. I should be able to live as I see fit. My taxes pay for them streets and alleys and dumpsters. I'll sleep where I want.
Sir, according to this, you haven't paid taxes in many years.
I seen the back of them Abraxo boxes. Not for consumption? Don't you tell me what to do. I'll eat what I want.
Hey, sir, you may just be the perfect candidate. How would you like to be the new overseer for Vault 114?
You're hired.
I ain't wearing no goddamn tie. Or pants.
Good. He's perfect.
Okay. Soup Can Charlie it is.
Harry.
Oh, Harry, sorry. Okay. Let's go on. Let's look at our quest here. So.
Oh, when she walked out of the place, a giant Brotherhood blimp loaded with attack planes or whatever flew by.
So, see, after observing a huge Brotherhood of Steel airship pass overhead, my Pip-Boy radio is receiving a transmission. I should listen to it for further instructions. Okay, there's more settlers.
I thought we had already decided on reunions.
Oh, we're gonna do reunions?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go.
Oh, and she upgraded her shotgun. A little bit. Not a lot.
Not a whole lot.
Just enough.
Alright, let's go discuss my findings with Piper.
Mm-hmm.
This should be fun.
Of course. Every issue of Grognak gives Barbarian perk. I love how every cover has an attractive female on it.
Draped over something or another.
Yep.
Alright, Piper.
My kind of comic series.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's in her house. Let's...
She spelled public wrong. I don't know if I pointed it out previously, but she spelled it wrong.
Oh, hi, Piper.
Well, well. Nikki Valentine walks into my office here
to pull the wool out from under your eyes.
You, me, and hard luck all seem to run together like acid rain down an old sewer.
You, including your client here in that analogy? So, you two are finally letting me in on this little case of yours. What's the story?
Where
do you want me to start? The part where Kellogg turned out to be working for the Institute? Or the part where he told me they have Sean?
The Institute. Oh boy. I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg.
He dead.
He dead, Jim.
Whatever you're thinking, it doesn't matter. He's dead.
Yeah, I knew he wasn't gonna go quietly the moment I saw him.
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
Well, considering I really didn't have a choice.
He wasn't gonna talk. Even if I had a way of bringing him alive.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
Gross.
I'm talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari.
You?
The mind behind the memories.
I'd love to see a brain sing.
Yeah.
Who's this Dr. Amari?
I'll let her give you her life story in person. Let's stay focused. I guess we're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I agree with Piper.
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
You already have something?
I guess. What do I have?
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the Memory Den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
Who are you taking?
I'm taking Nick. Sorry, Piper, but I don't really trust you.
It's you and me, Nick.
Let's get going. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
While you two are out, I'm gonna do some more research. I'll be here if you need me.
Yeah, you just stay here and think about what you did. Oh no, the picture! No!
Ew, bouncing brains. Alright, I guess. Oh, shoot. You know what? I should have brought with me all the stuff I needed to sell back from home. Oh well. It's
you
gonna
don't
still
need
be
to
there.
Sell nothing.
Even good people do crazy things when they're scared. Ought to be Diamond City's motto.
What's the motto?
Nothing. What's the motto with you?
Dad says not to talk to strangers.
Alright, let's go and check out, see if there's any adhesive.
I was thinking the same thing.
My friends say outside is
hey,
yeah, great minds think alike.
Check good in with you a friend. Ever need is
how's
right
the
news here?
Game?
We don't have it. It's inconceivable.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
The highest quality available.
All right.
Now let's look through.
Yeah. See if there's anything. No. Nope. Pompadour wig.
Make Nick wear it.
And a longshoreman outfit.
No.
Metal helmet.
Nah.
I don't think you need any of that stuff.
Unless there was some of that one thing that I need. The mutt fruit?
Mute fruit.
Mute fruit, that's it.
It's not mutt fruit. I've heard other people call it mutt fruit, and it's not. Buy the lunchbox, those are rare.
And we'll take the bobby pins.
Yep.
Okay, adhesive.
You can't have any. You're not allowed to have adhesive. You've been banned.
Sorry. I might have been. Oh, there's some.
Pack of duct tape. Say what? Well, there's a shipment.
Yeah.
You're actually not that far away. Quite honest with you. It's a future possibility for sure.
Yeah,
that's it.
That's it. Except
that's all she wrote, folks. The only other robot. Alright. So, did you want to cut out briefly and take care of all your selling needs?
No, I'll just come back.
You know,
Nick? He's sitting down at the job again.
Yeah, well, as she was looting the place, every few minutes he would sit down at the nearest, like, chair, yeah, and have a cup of coffee.
Yes.
Although, I'm very skeptical that he actually drinks coffee.
Oh, come on, Nick, let's get the heck out of Dodge.
You see that big blimp? What's the Brotherhood of Steel? Why are they here?
I don't see the blimp.
I don't see the blimp either. I'm looking.
Yeah.
I'm looking.
Let's just get out of here.
Alright, let's see. Let's put this up on the...
Where are you going? Oh. Oh, that's actually not very far at all.
Not very far at all from the sewer where I found Nick.
Yeah, well.
Back we go, I guess.
Yep. At least they're making it easy on you. Ooh, look at that. That is pretty. Assault rifle, combat rifle. Ooh-hoo. That's what you need. An assault rifle or a combat rifle. Look at that. That is a gun right there. That is pretty.
Which reminds me, what do I have in my hands? I might still have the combat shot.
Yeah, you have the shotgun. You want to switch off the shotgun?
Well,
go with something a little bit more medium range. If you had more ammo, I'd say try out Kellogg's pistol, but I think you have like 40 bullets for it.
How much do I have for this thing?
700-something.
Or do this.
Yeah, every time you fight the Institute, you get a lot of ammo.
So it's this way, actually.
Looks like it. I'm betting
any
minute.
One of my cases dead end in Boston Common. Mm. I'd prefer not to join them.
Bet any minute you get jumped by super mutants.
Oh, probably. It sounds about right.
Or ghouls. Maybe ghouls and super mutants.
What noise?
Super mutants.
They're here somewhere.
Actually, that sounds like ghouls and super mutants. Wow, did I call it? Oh, man. I totally just called it. Like, we haven't even done this part before, so...
Why are you...
I guess...
Apparently, you have a death wish.
Won't be chewing on us. Anyone you walk away from.
And then you got your friends behind you.
My way.
Yeah. Well,
maybe I can sneak by him, them.
Yeah, must have been nothing.
Yeah, must have been nothing. Just ignore the little bird. Tweet, tweet.
Tweet.
Yeah.
They're right over there.
I think you can probably avoid them. If you don't pick a fight with the mutants, they won't pick a fight with you. Everyone knows that mutants are peace-loving creatures.
Mm-hmm, they just want big hugs and cuddles.
I think you're right. Oh.
What the hell was that?
Oh, behind you. A raider scavenger, huh? Well, you might want to just take that guy out.
I gotta get down there, though.
Yeah, there's a wall in the way. So, oh man, there's a lot of raiders over here. There is a lot of raiders. You could queue up and use your crit strike, too. Try and take out as many raiders as you can in one VATS round. I think you could do it. Oh. It would only work if you're doing one shot per, and each shot would have to hit. It'd be pretty dicey. Nope, none of the shots hit. I don't think they know you're here. Well, I guess in that case, I got behind cover. Well, you got one of them. Hey, you got two of them. Nice shooting, Dex.
Thank you.
Scared, huh?
I think this guy is not gonna be too much of a problem.
Now that's one way to get that coolant pumping.
Well, I guess it's good that you don't have coolant in your veins. That would probably kill you.
Yes. But that's his adrenaline, so.
Yeah. Nick's a weird one. What?
It's a monkey.
Shoot the monkey. The monkey had to die. Na 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 na.
Na 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 na.
Stupid monkey. Sometimes you just gotta smack that monkey.
Alright, so we gotta go back this way and find a way down.
Or up? No?
No, not up. Down, Roawyn. Down.
Up. Up and down the same direction. See, this is a wall, Aywenn.
Yeah.
I think going around...
We gotta go back around by the super mutants.
You sure?
What do you want me to do?
Up it towards looks... the raiders.
Well, fine. You think I...
Trust me. I'm an expert.
Mm-hmm. The guy who gets lost when you put him in a closet.
I have
a very... Do you want to go up there and see if it's up there?
Yeah. I have a very keen directional sense, mind you. I have never gotten lost a day in my life when I didn't mean to. I just mean to be lost all the time. Maybe I just enjoy a perpetual state of confusion. Huh? Did you ever think about that?
No, I didn't.
Well, maybe you should try it sometime. Let's see.
Yeah, that's all that's on the outside.
So try going through this passage here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is a...
It's a dead end.
Well, darn. I tried. My best.
You wash your hands of it all now, right?
Yeah, you're on your own, kiddo. It's all up to you here.
Well, let's see if this actually lets us down and around, maybe.
Oh, you're gonna try to keep going?
Well, I'm already halfway down through around here.
Yeah,
you
can
either that or go the other way and fight super mutants.
You could. Sounds exciting. Give the people what they want. The people demand blood. Blood sacrifice, Aywenn. Your blood is a small price to pay. What?
No, I do not want to die.
Well, nobody's saying you have to die. I mean, just...
Just bleed a lot?
Just bleed a lot, yes. I think you're gonna have to stand to loot this. But that's a moot fruit. Oh, yeah.
No, it's a mutt fruit. M-U-T.
Mute. Mute, like in mutant. It's a mutant fruit. It's not mutt fruit. Well, that's one way. It was just like, never mind this, shove, turn around. They're on the ground, right there. They're just small and brown, and they blend in with the brown debris.
Maybe if we go this way?
Possibly. I mean, it's a potential of being a way to go.
Wow, this doesn't look like super mutant territory at all.
I mean, probably not.
We're going the other direction. Nick, this way.
Nick's got the right idea. He's not afraid. Nick's gonna just dive right in. I mean, he is not really human, so it's not like it's gonna really be painful if he gets shot.
They probably have some kind of sensors that would make it painful for him.
You think so? I don't know. A robot's a robot, a robot. I mean, you got cyborgs, you got androids, you got robots. And I guess synthetics, which are, you know, attempting to make synthetic humans, but I still think a synthetic is pretty much a robot. They're all the same in the end. Well, except for cyborgs. Cyborgs are organic with machine parts. So...
too bad I can't get down there.
Well, I mean, you could try.
I doubt it.
Yeah, it looks like a wall to me.
Yeah, it looks pretty... that's probably what they did it for, because they're in the middle of a super mutant.
Yeah, probably. Considering, like, every 5 inches you could spit and hit a super mutant. Hey, maybe they left.
Huh? What's that?
Or not. Nick, you might want to get your gun out of her face.
Yeah, please.
Anyway, it's just a regular super mutant. You fought worse.
The wrong synth.
I mean, it's not like the super mutants in Fallout 3 in New Vegas that were basically like super tanky. These things are actually... oh! That is a legendary mutant. That is a problem. Did that crit miss? Oh man. Okay. Stim back. Yeah. Aywenn's in serious trouble, folks. I can't even watch Mutt Chops. There you go. Oh yeah, another one coming. Fun. Oh, there's your... oh! Or you could just do that, I suppose. It's one way to resolve your problems.
House.
Oh, Nick. He handled that all himself. Well, what are you here for, then? Maybe you should go for the legendary one quick. See if there's anything good. What?
I just want to make sure Nick doesn't start shooting.
He looks like he's about to. You gotta watch out for Nick. He's pretty squirrely.
Wouldn't want it going to waste now, would we?
What? What going to waste, Nick? Oh. Well, there, Raider. And you're overburdened.
Oh, God. Jeez Louise. Nick, get your butt in here.
Well. Where's the leader?
He's a...
We definitely want to get the stuff off the legendary guy. I will laugh. Well, wait, you have to tell people to equip stuff. I was gonna say, I would laugh so hard if Nick equipped some of this stuff, he would look goofy. Or are you planning to just keep him, vanilla? Keep him looking the way
something
he
you
looks.
Need?
Okay, didn't I goo him?
You don't goo things.
Ash pile them. Oh, there.
Penetrating laser musket. 30% of the target's damage and energy resistant? That's pretty darn good.
Yeah, but it's one of those prank ones again.
Yeah. Still, pretty impressive. Alright.
Alan, what is it?
There's about 2 more in here somewhere.
Nothing.
Okay. I think there's about 2 more in here. I think from the dots.
Yeah. Seems about right.
Okay. They're laying out Raiders on the table. Oh, there's a dog.
Dinner table.
I guess. Do super mutants just eat other things like that?
I don't know. I think super mutants eat people.
Nick, move.
I thought you gave him a laser. machine gun. There's laser submachine gun.
Psst.
Do something for you? If I got it.
I think he's probably out of ammo again. That's probably what happened. 45 rounds.
Ugh. Nick.
Yeah. Give him like 500.
Yeah, I'm going to.
He's probably going to burn through them at an alarming rate, but...
Thank you, Nick.
That also seems more like detective-y. Well, I guess a pistol is pretty detective-y.
Yeah.
But that's a Tommy gun. And Tommy guns are awesome. Ugh. These meat bags.
Someone there! No, nobody here but us rats.
You just called
yourself
a rat.
Game's over!
Oh, good. Oh, not a good time to get into a firefight. Oh boy.
Don't think I'm getting jacked.
Yeah, you might want to give some of your stuff to Nick so you can move. Nick? Nick, Nick killed one.
Damn!
I think this thing's door you can actually pick open.
We'll snoop him out.
Snoop him out?
Alright.
Yeah, well, it all worked out.
Hey.
Yeah.
He already burned through 70 ammo. Ugh. That didn't take long.
Didn't want to give him that.
No, obviously you don't want to give him your good items.
No. Oops. What did I just... This one? No.
Strength and studded leather, right arm. Yeah, that's it.
Go ahead.
Okay, I'm gonna want to re...
Yeah, put it back on.
Alright. Pick the lock.
Oh.
Yeah, you didn't realize that was the door? Yeah. Locks. Locks are the worst kind of people. Well, her failing to open it does amuse me, so there's that. What? You seem...
Wasn't nervous. This behind where I wanted to go, though?
Way down in Kokomo?
Way down in Kokomo.
possibly. I don't know,
possibly, but let's clean out the rest of this stuff here.
You might have to take a trip back to drop off your loot. You're filling up really, really quickly. Yeah. There's like arms and feet sticking out of these bags.
That's why they call them meat bags.
Yum, yum, yum.
Hey.
What?
Well, you know, you gotta give the super mutants some props. At least they're keeping their food off the ground. A lot of it's hung up high.
Not all of it, though.
That's true. I mean, what exactly is the point of them hanging their food? I mean, does it, like,
well, some
try
people.
It out?
Well, there might be things that might want to eat it.
Not very much. But, I don't know.
It's the plan.
There is no plan, Nick. It's the best kind of plan.
Got everything out of here, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, we gotta go upstairs.
Why, what's upstairs?
It might be something cool.
Ugh. That super mutant twitched.
shoot it lots.
Probably.
Oh, wow. Must be like a hotel?
Maybe. Ah, mole rat teeth. Yum, yum, yum. That was a desk fan. You, like, looked right at the desk fan. Then you chose not to take it.
I chose not.
You gonna aim up high and try and get that meat bag on high?
The meat bag on high.
I don't know. Oh, lo, look upon high. There is a meat bag up in the rafters.
Yay.
Praise be the meat bag. I don't know where I'm going with this. Kind of disgusting now that I think about it. Probably drip on you as you walked underneath.
Probably.
It's pretty gross.
Yeah.
I mean, unless you're into that sort of thing.
Yes. Meat bag drippings.
Yeah, yeah. I guess we know which side of the fence Aywenn's on.
Ugh, the yuck, that's gross side.
Oh, you just sounded pretty enthused about the meat bag drippings. I'm just saying. You might have to fast travel soon and go drop off stuff. I'm seeing that as a foreseeable consequence there.
Well, I'm hoping that the doctor has things to buy and sell.
Are you sure it's not going to be a dungeon? The word dungeon used rather loosely, but same general precept. Interesting.
There wasn't much up there, was there?
No, but now we got some stairs. There definitely is a lot of vertical area used in this game, huh?
What is that? That is where... Isn't that where I'm headed? No.
That looks like another mutant. Use your zoom in on your gun. You have a thingy. Well, that's a person.
Those are either raiders...
Gunners.
Gunners.
They're hostile. Shoot.
What?
Yeah. Might as well take them out from on high. You do have a crit saved up, too.
I'm not gonna use it on these guys.
Oh, they're hitting pretty good. Get him, Nick! I mean, you're getting more experience from these folks than the superheroes. It's a little sad. That's Nick unloading like 5,000 rounds into the person. Nick! Tell you, you give that man an inch, he takes a mile.
He's not even hitting.
No, he's not. But he's certainly showing the foliage what for. He's occasionally hitting, I'll give him that. Wow, 7% and you hit. Pretty wacky odds. I'm impressed.
Should I even go down there, though? That's not where I want to go.
I don't know. It's a path. It gets you back on the ground.
Yeah, but it might not be the right path. Nick, move.
Right path, wrong path. They all lead the same way. It'll be good for you, kiddo. You know, and... teaches you a valuable life lesson.
Anything useful?
Not really. And now you're full.
Hey.
What? You seem, overburdened.
Now, see what I can do.
Can't do much about this, Nick. Can't do much. I guess come over here, discover a location, and then drop all your stuff.
Pretty
mass
much.
Fusion building. Yeah. I would find... there's probably, like, some kind of container over here you can shove all your stuff into.
Hopefully.
I'd be very surprised if
somebody went to a lot of effort to keep folks out of here.
Yeah? Ugh. What? You're not gonna go behind the barricade to look for loot boxes?
Then there's some behind the barricade? I think it was just a barricade.
I don't know. Looks promising. Or not. Guess there's not much here. Oh, that is unfortunate. That is unfortunate indeed.
At least I didn't die off it.
Oh, no, you didn't. That, certainly could have gone better, though.
Oh, yeah.
Grilled rat steak. Does that actually make it so you can move? If you stand up, are you...
No, I'm still...
Here we go.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so what are we gonna put in here?
I don't know. Everything? Toss a few of those items, just enough so you can fast travel. That'll probably do it, too.
Nope.
Laser pistol?
Nope.
Yeah, that gotcha. Alright, folks, we will be RB and a little B. Aywenn's gotta do some, personal maintenance.
Personal maintenance. Alright, folks, see ya. Welcome back, folks. We are back here at the Mass Fusion, and we just heard a settler go, eh!
And then large explosions.
Yeah, well...
And then... Is that a helicopter?
Sounds like it, but... Don't know where it is.
Or I should say bird-a-bird. Excuse me. That is definitely a vertebrate. Just gained experience.
Okay.
Things are suddenly going crazy around there.
Yeah? Interesting. Whoa!
I don't know what's happening.
Well.
Interesting. And that's where she stashed all her loots.
I don't see the vertebrate. I hear it, but I don't see it.
Well, over here is where you're heading.
Yep. Good neighbor.
Oh, man. This is terrifying. Air raid!
Mm-hmm. Oh. Someone didn't make it.
And there's more chaos happening. Alpha Vicious Mongrel. Well, making friends already, huh? Well, this should level you. Oh, she upgraded Nick's rod. So hopefully, even though he'll be wasting ammo, hopefully he's wasting less ammo. At least that's the theory.
That's the theory.
Yeah.
That dog is caught.
Yeah, it is. Yes. Yes,
Nick,
they do.
What are you shooting at?
Nick?
Nick?
I don't know what he's up to. You did level, though, so we want to take care of that quick.
That's how you imagined it, though.
No? That's not how I imagined it would go down at all. A dog collar. Give that to dog meat.
Yeah, when I see him again. Nick's probably gonna get me killed.
Yeah, he detects something over here is why he's...
I'll be doing the world a service.
There's obviously somebody over there.
Nick! I'm going this way.
Why? Did you see something?
No, I didn't see nothing.
No.
Nick's being...
You're in there, for it now.
There's the...
Yeah. I don't know. Let's just head where we're supposed to go. This is getting weird. True?
Yes.
Oh, here's another dead guy. People are just dying for no reason. Must be a sudden outbreak of heart attacks.
This is the Freedom Trail, folks.
Oh. Freedom Trail marker. Examine it.
Now a six and a no.
Okay.
It must be for your one quest.
See, this is... Some places it's actually bricks, and sometimes it's just painted on the road like this.
Oh.
Nick!
Why, have you actually followed the Freedom Trail?
Parts of it, yeah.
Ah.
It's quite a long... I don't remember how many miles long, but it's quite a lengthy thing. Nick, we're going through here. I don't know what you're doing, but get your...
Ooh, turn around. What's that poster? Girls. I like it. We need to go there.
Alright, we're going in here.
Oh, level up.
Yeah.
Or not. What? Why are you looking at me like that?
Because every second I can't just be a level without having the...
No.
Oh, hello.
This is a town.
Mm-hmm. Fine. What do you want?
I want all the perks.
Do we want to go with that one?
Yeah. I mean, why wouldn't you go with that one?
Considering we were putting points into charisma to get this.
Okay. There you go. Now, how you use it, we don't know, but...
We'll work on it.
Yeah. It's a start.
Nick, put your gun away, please. Don't shoot the people. They're not shooting us.
Well. It's the detective. Tracking down another wayward husband to his mistress?
Why? Someone stand you up?
You trying that, what do you call it? Evasive language on me? And who are you, huh? Valentine's new dick in training?
Oh, wow.
I'm not gonna answer you.
Not your concern.
Oh, it's not, huh? Well, with that attitude, you're gonna be in the market for a little insurance.
Hey, it's a friendly insurance salesman.
Insurance?
That's right. Insurance. Personal protection, like. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Whoa. Well, probably good to get insurance against
Valentine
that.
Valentine makes a rare visit to town, and you're hassling his friend here with that extortion crap? Good to see you again, Nick.
Hancock?
What do you care? She ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn. I said let her go.
Who do you think actually won the war?
You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something.
Oh, stab!
Now, why'd you have to go and say that, huh? Breaking my heart over here. You all right, sister?
Yeah, fine. Hancock? Sure, I'm fine.
I'm fine. Thanks for taking care of him.
Good. Now don't let this incident taint your view of our little community. Good neighbors of the people, for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
This place seems pretty rough.
Good neighbor. That what you call this place?
That's right. We cobbled this little neighborhood together out of the freaks and misfits that just wouldn't be accepted anywhere else. You'll see. You make enough friends here, you'll call this place home soon enough. So long as you remember who's in charge.
You are, Hancock. You are. Oh, I can actually loot him.
You're gonna steal his sweet roll?
Of course.
Well, someone should make use of it.
And the sweet roll?
Exactly, Nick. As Nick says, someone should make some use out of it.
You took his sweet roll.
Alright, so...
Oh, go to guns.
That's the old... Oh, that's the old state house? Oh, cool.
Guns.
Daisy's discounts? Another ghoul?
Yeah. It's probably it. What?
Ah, hi!
Kill Leo!
Hello. Everything here is guaranteed to injure, maim, or kill at your discretion. Except me. I only kill when I want to.
Hooray?
Alright.
There's a fat man and mini nuke behind the counter.
Who? What are you?
I'm a woman, baby. Can't you tell?
Sure, you're a woman.
You certainly look like a woman, yes.
Then that's all that matters, right? Now, are you buying what I'm selling?
close up!
Sure, what's
so percent? What kinds of weapons do you have?
Anything that can kill a man, I sell. Except suicidal depression. That is unfortunately not packageable. Now, are we doing business?
I like Cleo or Killio or whatever.
Let's see what you have.
Murder and mayhem at a discount.
Lovely.
She's my new friend.
Okay, so... yeah, sell her that.
Yeah. And the Knuckles.
Yep.
Oh, and Comfort Tune Pipe Revolver Pistol. Yeah, might as well. Laser Pistol. Pipe Bolt Action Pistol. Pipe Pistol. Keep the dog collar, yeah. And all that can sell. As can most of that.
Do we have raw leathers?
Yeah.
Okay.
She's trying to keep one of every item.
Alright.
And what does Cleo have? I think it's probably Cleo.
Okay.
Laser sniper rifle. Compensator. So nothing interesting so far.
A party starter. 50% more damage to humans.
Look at the price.
Ouch. Yeah, I don't have
Let's get this party started!
A puncturing sledgehammer.
Let's get it started.
Yeah! Okay, apparel. Cage armor?
No idea. There might be
temporary slows time during combat when you're at 20% health or less.
Look at the price.
Ouch. We're coming back here when we actually have money.
They'll probably have different stuff.
I know, but I have no money.
No. Power armor frame?
I don't have enough money. I don't have enough money.
No, you don't.
Cryo
cells, huh?
What ammo do I use with my laser,
you use, fusion cells?
Might as well buy it.
That's pretty expensive.
Yeah, let's not. Let's just accept what we got.
Yeah. You can buy fusion cores for your power armor. That's pretty sweet.
Did you see the price on them?
Yeah, that's pretty pricey.
Mm-hmm. All right. See you later, Cleo.
Daisies.
Brotherhood of Steel. Better stay out of good neighbor. All I'm saying.
All right, Daisy.
A new face walks into my store. And you're not even screaming yet. Very polite. You let me know if anything catches your fancy.
All right.
Screaming?
Did you say something about people screaming at you?
That's right. Some newcomers have never seen a ghoul before. Can't handle a friendly face, I say. So you need some supplies?
Yeah, fair enough. I can see where.
What's it like, you know, being a ghoul?
Well, it's a lot worse when people always ask you about it all the time.
Oh, no.
But I guess I can't blame them. On the upside, I look pretty good for being over 220 years old. Now, were you buying anything?
Yeah, I wonder what's the maximum life expectancy for a ghoul?
I don't know.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Yeah, like sure, Trey. Let's
get started. Too.
All right, so... definitely not the weapons that Cleo has.
No.
Destroyers.
Oh, wait. That's actually not too unaffordable.
Yeah, well, I don't have
the... speed, yeah.
Don't have the money at this point.
Why not, Aywenn? Why not?
Because it's expensive to buy all the adhesive I need?
No.
I'll take the bobby pins.
Yeah.
Let's see, where anything that's got adhesive?
Yep, duct tape has adhesive.
And, that's a
shipment.
She's
got a shipment, yeah. No adhesive for you. Adhesive.
That's it.
Well, it's a start. It's at least more places to get the stuff.
Right, okay, so.
Oh, did you want to see what quest she had?
Oh, she had a quest?
Yeah. Anytime anyone has work, they have a quest.
Chances are we have whatever you're looking for.
Oh.
Got any work?
I do, actually. Super mutants have taken over the old Boston Public Library. I got a lot of fond memories of that place from when I was a girl and human. You get those lumbering brutes out of there, I'll pay you 200 caps.
200 caps is not very much.
No, but...
Anything more you can tell me about the library?
A lot of those pre-war buildings have automated security. Robots, turrets, that kind of thing. A lot of computers, too. Hope you take the job. You might not believe this, but I was a shy child. Books were like my best friends growing up.
Fair enough.
Okay, well, I probably will fail asking for more money, so
you
sure.
Got a deal, Daisy.
Thanks. Hey, while you're there, could you return this book for me?
Oh, Valentine,
it's from the library. Don't even ask how long it's been overdue.
Okay. Yeah,
fair enough. Oh, that's where you take the overdue books.
Oh, cool. Well, that would be a good quest then, because I've got some of those. Nick's sitting on the job again.
He's a lazy robot.
Okay, so that's the old state house.
You're looking for the brain drain.
Yep, yeah, what's this? A warehouse that's...
locked.
The third rail.
Going in there?
Mm-hmm. See who's in here.
Cause you're going off the rail on a crazy train.
Ooh, hi.
Hancock says newcomers
Ham.
Are welcome in the third rail. Go on in.
Ham.
Hey.
Downstairs. Don't bother the other patrons.
Okay. Well,
his name is Ham.
I'd rather be Bacon.
Bacon is a delicious name. The corner. Mm. Yeah, you probably don't want to start making enemies.
No.
Oh. Pull up a chair. Somebody's singing.
Yeah. Cool. No, that's her. To
feel like whoever this Brotherhood of Steel is, I'm not buying that we come in peace malarkey.
What? Another one of you mercs looking for MacReady?
It's like a speakeasy.
He's in the back room.
Talk to MacReady. Have you got a
history that needs this seems like where I'd be hanging out.
Well, hey there. Did you
come in just I like the atmosphere.
So do I.
Oh, hey. Yeah, I'm doing all right. It's hard without Gwen.
God, I love this song.
Yeah, that's real good to hear. Well, I just wanted to check in.
MacReady was back here. Did anything? We want to see MacReady or did
yeah,
we want to
just... let's go there.
You got it.
Before we get, like, you know, hell yeah. Copyright I'm surprised to find you in a dump like this,
MacReady. I was wondering how long it would take your bloodhounds to track me down, Winlock.
Oh.
It's been almost 3 months. Don't tell me you're getting rusty. Should we take this outside?
It ain't like that. I'm just here to deliver a message.
In case you forgot, I left the Gunners for good.
Yeah, I heard. But you're still taking jobs in the Commonwealth. That isn't going to work for us.
I don't take orders from you.
I don't know either.
Anymore. So why don't you take your girlfriend and walk out of here while you still can?
What? Winlock, tell me we don't have to listen to this shit.
Listen up, MacReady. The only reason we haven't filled your body full of bullets is that we don't want a war with Good Neighbor. See, we respect other people's boundaries. We know how to play the game. It's something you never learned.
Glad to have disappointed you.
Like a good neighbor.
You can play the tough guy all you want. But if we hear you're still operating inside Gunner territory, all bets are off. You got that?
You finished?
Yeah. We're finished. Come on, Barnes.
Look, lady. If you're preaching about the Atom or looking for a friend, you've got the wrong guy. If you need a hired gun, then maybe we can talk.
Okay.
Maybe. Why don't you tell me who those guys were first?
A couple of morons looking to climb the ladder of success by stepping on everyone else on the way up. Shouldn't be surprised, though. That's how it goes when you run with the Gunners.
Gunners, huh?
Never heard of the Gunners. Who are they?
One of the biggest gangs in the Commonwealth. Got a rep for being crazy. You know, so tightly wound, you'd think they were a cult or something? Stuck with them for a while because the money was good, but it never fit in. That's why I made a clean break and started flying solo. Now what about you? How do I know I won't end up with a bullet in my back?
Because you'd probably just shoot him in the face if you were going to shoot him.
Are you always this suspicious?
Hey, you approached me. And frankly, I'm taking a huge risk being out here in the Commonwealth in the first place. So I'm not about to leave anything to chance. Which brings me back to my original question. Can I trust you?
Absolutely not. She looks shady.
Hold on. What kind of risk are you talking about?
I already told you way too much. Need to learn to keep my big mouth shut. Look, I'm tired of playing 20 questions. So I'll cut you a deal right now. 250 caps. Up front. And there's no room for bargaining. What do you
say? I'm not gonna pay for you to come join me. I'll think about it.
Let me think about it.
It's not like the meter's running. Take your time. I got plenty.
Okay.
Well, I'm glad to hear the meter is not running.
Sounds good. Let's get the heck out of here.
So you can hire him as a companion.
Basically. Well.
Sweet Pip-Boy, sister. Oh, you hold on to that.
There's the singer.
Yeah.
Huh? Magnolia. Don't have your hand out.
Excuse me, miss. Lady.
Well, what's the matter, sweetheart? Don't tell me you didn't like the song.
Sounds lovely.
I loved the song. It was perfect.
There ain't nothing like real jazz.
Oh, well, thank you. A girl tries her best. Now, there's something special about you, isn't there? Don't tell me. Let me guess. It's your eyes. Quick and intense. I bet you never miss a detail, You like what you see?
She's
so what brings
with you.
A woman like you?
Yeah, don't swing that way. Sorry. What do you think?
I came here for the music.
Flatterer, I think you and I are going to get along. So it's my turn to answer questions, right? What can I do for you?
I am not flirting.
Totally flirt with her. Do it.
What's your story?
No.
How'd you end up singing here?
Oh, I flew into town like any songbird does on a heavy wind with a wounded wing. Well, this place has a stage I needed to sing, and Whitechapel Charlie needed customers, so here we are. Was there anything else?
Whitechapel Charlie?
Yeah.
Whitechapel Charlie's been here a long time, I take it.
Well, he never talks too much about his past. Neither do I, really. I guess that's why we get along. You should get to know him, though. Order a drink first. He always wants to talk business after someone's had a few. And was that all? You need anything else?
Flirt.
Come on. Tell me the whole story. Who were you before all this?
You really want to know? It's all in the songs. Everything I am. Now, can I help you with anything else?
She definitely has, like, a noir feel to her.
Nothing.
Or noir.
I'll leave you to it.
You have a good one.
Okay, Whitechapel Charlie.
Hey.
Nope, Drifter.
Let me ask you something.
Drifter. Oh, whoa.
Nick wanted to talk
to you. Yeah, I was going to say, Nick just... Where'd he go? Oh, hi, Nick. Something wrong?
Is something wrong?
Well, I sort of had the same question. It's just, with everything that's happened with you and your family, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
What? Where's this all coming from?
Yeah, why?
Why do you ask?
I just had a hard go with the, transition myself. Took me a long damn time to get a feel for this place. Thank goodness I found Diamond City. It's got its flaws, sure, but it beats the hell out of anywhere else in the Commonwealth. Of course, when I took up there back when, people were just as scared of the Institute as they are now. Maybe more. The massacre of the CPG was still pretty fresh in people's minds at that point. And folks were still losing sleep over the broken mask. Plenty of people assumed I was just a saboteur, moving in to melt down the reactor or poison the drinking water. But at the time, they couldn't exactly turn me away.
Why was that?
They let you join them?
Why'd they let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter.
Oh.
Now of about 15. Pride and joy of the mayor back then. A man by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd known for an evening.
Uh-huh.
Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. I didn't even know who I was rescuing. Just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. Hmm. I took her home and the mayor dubbed me a hero.
Wow.
Offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested, said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was, and people seemed to warm to that.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
Was it hard settling in?
Yeah, they sure didn't make it easy.
I'm sure
I started
not.
Off doing the jobs no one else wanted. I got more banged up being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins. But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing. Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her. Talk to the synth.
Fair enough.
An upset father decides moving him and the kids to Good Neighbor in the dead of night's not the worst damn idea since the bomb. Go get Nick. After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore. Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see.
Yeah.
It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this place can be home for you, too. It's a long story, but I hope it helps. Want to get moving?
Better keep your iron strapped on.
Okay.
Friendly advice.
So, Drifter.
Ever been to Kill or Be Killed?
We should probably wrap it up shortly.
No.
Oh, boy, that's...
We got beer.
Oh, wait.
If you ain't buying beer, you ain't buying...
That's Whitechapel Charlie?
Yeah, I guess.
He's got a British flag on him.
Let's see what you got.
Here's the Drowning Solos.
It's a robot bartender.
Yep, it is. Remember, we get drunk and we talk to the robot.
Sweet roll.
We get drunk, dear, not...
You're buying some beer and bourbon from him?
Yeah, I'm gonna get drunk.
Okay. Fair enough.
Let's see if that'll get me drunk. Oops.
Alright then, I don't know what she is suddenly
doing. Now
that
you're liquored up, got a proposition for you. I need a dirty girl to do some dirty work. Blood on the pavement, bodies in the ground, that kind of thing. Interested?
I wasn't expecting this.
Details?
I want to hear the details first.
I got a certain anonymous client who's paying top dollar for a clean-up job. 3 locations. Everyone inside. No witnesses. Only catch? It's all in town. The old warehouses, so I can't use my regulars. Too noticeable. That's where you come in. The job's 200 caps. Payment after it's done. Don't worry. I'll know when it is.
This is terrifying.
Yeah, I don't know.
He's a mob boss robot.
A British mob boss robot.
It's like the worst kind of mob boss robot.
I don't do work, unless I know who's paying the bills.
Not your concern. Now, you're taking the job or what?
No. That's too many variables. Too many variables for 200 caps.
Try to ask for money.
No, I'm not.
It's random murder. I'm out.
Think you're too good for this town, mate? You're not.
Oh, shamble.
I'm like that, yep. I don't know who I'm shooting. I don't know.
Peace, sister.
Peace, sister.
What,
okay.
You
and your scruples.
Fred Allen, Hotel Rexford. He'll hook you up.
Scruples.
All right, folks. I guess Ron was trying to say that that was the end of the episode, so...
Scruples!
I guess that's the end of this episode. Roawyn, would you like to sign off?
Scruples!
Bye, folks.
Bye.